fellow Lions and guests. I've got three happy dollars. One's for Joe Daggy. One's for Kurt and Ignostu. And another one's for Rick Johnson. You know, they don't get here very often, but we're glad you're here today. And my other happy dollar. And another happy dollar is the fact that we spent the weekend with our family. Our daughter from Ohio was here and brought her son and a boyfriend that looks like he's going to be a part of our family, so we're pretty excited about that. The blessing is that he adores her and we really like him, so that's a good deal. He's tall. He is tall. And he loves to hug his whole family, so he's a hugger. Please stand. Our invocation today will be led by Larry Hansen.
Our Heavenly Father, we come before you with much praise and thanks for the fellowship we have here today, and for the food you give and strengthen us, for the service you've called to us as Lions. May we ever be grateful and praiseful of you for all that you give to us and strengthen us and encourage us in wisdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Our flag salute today will be led by 3rd VP Leroy.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, and liberty and justice for all.
And past president John Claypool will be leading our singing. Who said that? Go for it, John.
Tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing. Land where my fathers died, land of thy pilgrim's pride, from every mountainside, let freedom ring.
I don't know, that sounded pretty rough. Do we want to do it again? So, tail twisters, we need a mic, yes, on Kathy Carmody.
Madam President, fellow Lions, John Palmer Sr., would you like to introduce your guest, please?
Welcome.
And you may count them if you wish, but we've got like a bazillion visitors from Castle Rock. If they would like to stand up.
Please stand up, Castle Rock.
Stand up.
Thank you. Welcome. And there's a couple other visitors here. Are they not signed up? Ron Johnson, Kelso, Early Birds. Is there another Early Bird here? Nope, that's it. Thanks for coming. That it? Okay, we're going to move on. Do we have any sunshine report, ladies? Okay. Our Cindy Sessions, our past president Cindy, who is our sunshine chair, isn't feeling too well today, so she is absent for that reason. So we're going to move on to announcements. The Taste of Italy. Leroy, do you have anything to offer with that for us? Because Carrie Ann's not here. It's March 25th.
March 25th is coming up. Those who want to go to baskets or they need some baskets, gift baskets or whatever, that will raffle off. Also, looking for wine donations. And who's collecting the wine again? Eric, who else?
Eric.
And Chris Watson. So if you guys bring some wine, the more wine that we have, probably the better, and that way you don't, whatever. Anyway. And Cindy said something about outdated wine, but I'm not sure if the outdated wine can actually happen. So bring good wine for the donations and
how about a bottle of true luck chuck?
That's not outdated, so that'll work. And Marnie Potero has got tickets. And so if you haven't got tickets, make sure you see hers, get tickets, and sell these things. This Taste of Italy goes for scholarships, and the more money, more tickets you sell, the more money you get, the more scholarship money we send out.
Thank you, Leroy. So our next announcement would be Ron Stoppler.
President Marilyn Felline, the guest, as head of health and welfare, I'm responsible for grant projects, and Bill Fines has been leading that. Being incapacitated, Rick Johnson has agreed to take over the job of building a ramp for someone who's going to buy the material for us. We're going to provide the labor.
Ski ramp, yeah.
Ski ramp. It's not a ski ramp. And he has a plan to build it in modules and then move it from his house to the site. So Rick has a sign-up sheet. When are you going to start, Rick? I'll let Rick tell you all about the details. This is a great job of Rick.
Right. Okay. Tomorrow, if anybody's available, if you want to meet at my house, we're going to start assembling the ramp. Basically, I'm going to build it in a module. I'm going to make three pieces, and I'll store it until March 1st. March 1st at 10 o'clock, if people want to meet at my house, we'll load the ramp up on a trailer, we'll take it up to the house, and then we'll start putting it there. So anyway, if anybody's available tomorrow at 11 o'clock at my house, 2316 Ocean Beach Highway, if you want to show up, we'll start building it. So, okay? And if anybody wants any information, I got some information.
11 o'clock?
11 o'clock. Thank you, Rick. That's great. Good. So our next announcements, you're over by Rex Boswell. We'll go with that. And thank you for doing that, Rick. Ron, thank you for finding him.
President Bell, and Bill Alliance guest. I'm going to have a work party Saturday morning at 9 o'clock down at the shop. Finish getting everything put away upstairs and getting that baby ready for the summer.
Our next announcement would be past Council Chair Hal Palmer and past District Governor Kathy Crawford.
Hey, thank you, President Marilyn. Bill Lyons, a guest. So, Kathy, I got this big question for you. What's happening in March?
Nothing.
There's a lot happening in March, but one of the biggest things going on in our multiple district, March is the Spring Ahead Membership Drive Month. Hopefully you've heard about it, but if not, I talked to Steve about this. We have contests going on, but it's not just a contest, it's just a good opportunity for you to focus on new members. We'll be giving away prizes of $300 each to the clubs in our multiple district. We have three size categories, so you're not out there competing percentage-wise with Vader, for instance. And so anyway, get a few new members in March. Anytime during March that those people, will compare your February numbers to your March numbers, the biggest percentage of increase in clubs 50 and over will win a $300 prize. And you could spend that on something very special. Same thing.
Same
thing. Yeah.
What's the speech?
Well, Hal must have gone to the dollar store. He's got a whole bunch of springs here. So if you're interested in springing ahead, see Hal. I'm sure he'll share a spring with you.
Yes, my challenge is, who right here wants to commit to be bringing a guest during the month of March? You get a spring to remind yourself.
Who will do that for us?
Who will do that? Greg, will you do that for us? Thank you, Greg. Please, membership chair, so we must. Anybody else? Greg? Oh, my goodness,
Donna.
Grandma back there.
Grandma? Where's Grandma? Donna Jessen. Donna. Hal? Donna. Over here.
Awesome.
Well, look at Wayne.
Oh, a couple back there.
Hal, we've got a bunch back here. Wow.
It's kind of like a, what am I bidding? Okay, you want to do that first, after
you
announcement?
Need to do it right.
Okay.
So he doesn't leave.
If you get two springs stuck together, you need to bring
any other notes.
Yes.
But you can see with a little bit of enthusiasm, you could bring in some new members in March with $300 that you could put towards one of your projects or one of your parties, however you want to spend that. That's up to you.
Thank you very much. Yes, Jim?
Are we going to have any pies involved?
No, no pies. I'm really
sorry about that. Leave the mic with Kathy, and I'm going to let her announce the crab feed and Napa Vine.
Jim Renneke, if Longview Pioneer Lions wins in their category, I will bring you a pie. How's that? Well, I got him to agree to that one time, as long as it was banana cream, I believe it was. He insisted on that. So, okay.
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 We've got a couple more announcements to go. Kathy, would you?
Okay, first of all, reminder, Vader Lions Club Crafty, thank you to the folks who have already purchased tickets. We need to call in our order by this Friday. Get a hold of me today if you think you might want to come, and we'll connect with you. Also, Napa Vine New Waukam Lions Club. They're our newest Lions Club in our district. They're almost 2 years old already. They're holding their second annual spaghetti feed March 12th. That's on a Sunday from 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Steve Patterson has some information. I have some tickets if you're interested, or you can just call and let them know that you're coming. And it was really, really good last year, and I hope you'll reach out and take advantage of the opportunity to go visit these fine folks. They're a great club.
Thank you, Kathy. And then now we'd like to have Barbara Haynes share a couple of words about their Castle Rock event.
Hello, all. We're very pleased to be here with you today. Thank you for the great reception that we have. In May, on May 11th, we are celebrating our 70th anniversary of the club. We will be having a baked potato and salad bar event at the RV, or the Trudel RV Resort, so just north of Castle Rock. In kind of planning the whole event, what I've done is I have made a quilt that we are using as a raffle item, and I have raffle tickets available today. Those tickets are $1. I guess I should back up and say the event tickets I also have with me today. They're $12. You have to buy a ticket in advance because we need to know how many baked potatoes to have. Just can't have them just kind of hanging out there. So now getting back to the raffle, tickets are $1 a piece. For today and today only, part of our giveaways at our event are going to be giving away old MD-19 pins. I've come across this one from the Longview Pioneer Club, and I understand that this is the second pin of the club. So anyone who buys a raffle ticket today, at the end of this meeting, I will draw from the pot and you will have a chance of being that wonderful pin. So, anyway, I've reached out to many of the tables, but if there are tables that have not been included, be sure to reach out to me ahead of time.
Here's one.
Make sure that you're taken care of.
There's a couple over there.
Okay.
So if you want to do that, that'd be great. Thank you, Barbara. That's all, Greg, I think, bring it up. So I have an announcement. February calendar kind of confuses us with the short months, but this Thursday will be our board meeting. So that is the 23rd at Bob Paul's at 7 a.m. Next week, District Governor Monty Ward will be here from the Kalama Club representing the district. So I hope that you'll all be able to attend. Monty's a great guy, and I'm sure that he'll have a nice message for us. Plus, just to support him in his job that he's chosen to volunteer for. Salvation Army Tonight dinner is at 6:30 and first VP Cindy Fickett and her husband are attending, and I was going to, but I'm unable to go. I did commit to three people, so is there anyone that would like to take my place? Kathy, that would be awesome. Thank you. So just see me after the meeting. Oh, I appreciate that. With that said, we have a new member, Octavio Camba, right? Did I do that right? Camba?
Close enough,
he says. Octavio is a student here in town at LCC, right?
Yes.
Okay.
They haven't kicked me out yet.
They haven't. And his sponsor is second VP Ken, and so Marnie's going to fill in for his sponsor today since Ken is going to be gone.
There's no grade.
And we'll let Ken know. So on that, Secretary Steve, past district governor.
Well, it's very appropriate that you're wearing a necktie today. This is generally a pretty relaxed club. Some people are still working. It's a pleasure today to welcome Octavio. He will be our first, actually, student member, so that the laws for the dues are a little bit different. So he does get a substantial discount, and he's had a benefactor. We're not going to say who, but your dues have been paid. And we're hoping that because you've chosen as a student to become a member of this, it's not really an old person's club, but there are there's plenty of people in here who could be your dad, and there's plenty of people in here that could be your grandpa. Anyway, we want you to know as you join that being in Lions Club is a privilege.
Well, I'll be sure to make this regrettable.
You are joining the world's largest service organization. We're a group of 1.3 million men and women around the world, 46,000 clubs in 208 countries. Our history dates back to 1917, when Lions Clubs International was formed by a Chicago businessman by the name of Melvin Jones. He believed that local business clubs should be working for the betterment of their communities and the world at large. In 1925, at their annual convention, Helen Keller was the guest speaker, and she challenged the Lions to become Knights for the Blind. We have lit a candle on your behalf, truly, to show that you will be dedicated to serving others. We want you also to know that this is a tradition to help bring the light to those that cannot see and those that cannot hear. We're primarily an organization for sight and hearing. You'll hear about that during your orientation. Behind you, if you look behind you, you'll see our emblem as a large letter L within a gold ring, and that certifies unity and strength. On either side of that ring is a lion's head, one looking back toward past accomplishments, one looking forward, ahead to a new accomplishment. Since you have expressed a desire to be a member of Pioneer, I would like you to respond to my words now with a simple I do. You accept membership in Pioneer Lions, knowing that you are encouraged to participate in all functions of the club.
I do.
To the best of your ability, will you abide by the Lions Code of Ethics, attend meetings, and contribute to the programs of your club, district, and Lions Club International? By the power vested in me by Lions Club International.
Cindy!
I now declare you officially a member of Pioneer Lions. Your sponsor will now present you with your lapel pin and inappropriately is for only those that are inducted this year, because it is the 100th year of Lions International. Okay? And the sponsor then will respond with a simple, "I will." You're saying this for your husband, so you're going to have to tell him. Will you fulfill the following obligations? Be a mentor for the new line. Will you make the new member feel welcome?
I will.
Will you introduce him to other club members and assist him in becoming an outstanding line? Okay? I personally would like to congratulate you. You're going to receive now a red badge. And that badge has your name on it. What? We'll fix it. Well, that's so when he looks at his badge, he'll see his name. Depends on what time of day I put those together. And your membership card. Be sure that you sign that membership card, because occasionally a tail twister will say, "Everyone in here show their membership card, and it better be signed. If you're not, if it isn't signed, then you're going to get fined." Now, one last thing. We're going to ask you to get rid of that red badge. You have to do four things so that you can get a permanent blue badge. And the permanent blue badge will have your name properly. Okay, are you going to take a stab at it? You have four things you need to do.
He may not have been coached on this. So.
Yeah.
I've not been informed.
He's not been told, so we'll help him out.
Okay, then he can't be a member. Get him
out. Yes, he can.
Okay.
You need to attend an orientation that tells you about our club and the higher levels of International Lions. A work party, which you've already helped. Didn't you help with some newspapers one day with Steve? Did you get a chance to do that? Any kind of work party. Okay.
Yes,
orientation,
yes, yes.
Work party, board meeting. You have to get up early for that. Really early. 5:30.
Really?
What's the other one? Visitation. We want you to visit another club just so you get to know other Lion clubs, recognize that we're all really different, and get to know other Lions in the area.
Okay. Since we do have a little bit of time, you have 1 minute to tell us about yourself.
Well, you can take
5 minutes. Octavio, tell us about yourself.
I'm going to take around 61 seconds. Okay. Break some rules. I'm a student over here at LCC. Right now I'm studying American government, and then I'm going to transfer and get a bachelor's in human development. I plan on doing a lot of social work here in Cowlitz County. That's really it. You know, I haven't had the opportunity to retire yet.
Anybody got a lottery ticket?
And really, I would just like to thank everyone for allowing me the opportunity to be of service to the community. I'm sure that my joining will bring the average age down.
Pioneer Lions, welcome Octavio.
I think Octavio is going to be just fine. He's got a little humor. He's going to bring some new and young energy into our group. So we're glad you're with us. At this point, I'd like to bring Steve back up. Yeah. Keep that microphone. Where is it? There you go. We have awards to give out today. And as you know, Cindy Sessions is not feeling well, and she is our awards chair. So Steve received a text just shortly before the meeting and said, "Can you do this?" And yes, we will.
Well, we still have a couple of members that we have not recognized yet from December, so we're going back a couple of months. And the first two are here. No, he didn't show up either. So, for...
I have him, I'm here.
Did you sign in, Rick?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's take a moment and recognize Judy Fromdahl for her efforts in December. What the heck
Christmas
did you
party.
Do? Oh, you put that Christmas party together. Yeah. Judy Fromdahl. Unsung line of the month. Okay, you're most welcome.
Let me blow that out.
Now for the month of, oh wow, we're getting close, January. We're getting real close. For, this will be Unsung Lion, and for his continued efforts with the ongoing Sight and Hearing Foundation here, we'd like to again recognize Unsung Lion of the Month, Greg Firth. Another Unsung Lion of the Month. Now we're in January still, so who's this guy? Oh, okay. You know, we put those lights up down at the island, and then we got to turn around after a month and take them down. Well, one of the hardest workers was the other Unsung Lion of the Month, and that's Bob Jessup. Bob? Bob?
Thank you. Hey, stop for a kiss from Bobby here.
Lion of the Month, January. This is getting fun. It's all about the island this time. Rex, is he still here?
Oh, he had to leave.
Oh, that dirty bum. Okay, I guess he has to go to class, huh? And we have what we like to, every once in a while, we like to recognize a rookie. A rookie is a member of the club that's been in the club less than 18 months. And this rookie will be very, very surprised. We like to recognize because he always has a smile on his face and tries to make everyone happy. And guess who? David Smith. David? Take your time, or we're out of awards.
I'd like to say...
Keep that smile. Wait a minute. We didn't say you could talk.
Okay.
But we're going to let you.
Speak right into the microphone.
I'd like to say in defense of take my time, I can move. You talk to anybody down at Goodwill, and everybody down there will tell you, he may look like he's slow, but when he was working, he was one of the fastest movers around there in that store. I had a 45-year manager, about 45 years old, and he did a testing for electronic appliances, and I was already done, and he was halfway through the program, trying to do it and showing others too. But anyway, I just hope I've always made everybody happy. Happier. I'm just happy to be able to make people happy. That's our adventure, and it should be in our life, and to serve God as best you can. Let's make people happy, too, in all the right ways.
That's good.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, Divin. Madam President, we're out of awards. We're out of people.
I thought he was going to say we were out of order. We're always out of order. You are welcome. So we have a couple of minutes here. How many of you have worked on Taste of Italy? Please show a hand. Okay. Is there anyone that would like to share something fun about that experience? I need a couple volunteers. Okay, there's one back there. Little Nazi. Grab that microphone. Share about how you became Noodle Nazi.
Back in the early days of the spaghetti feed, I can remember when we out back that cooked all the spaghetti got tired of tasting and tasting and tasting. So we said, you know, the spaghetti's really ready if you take it and throw it up against the wall, and it sticks. Well, there we are behind St. Rose's, and we got this whole wall just full of this spaghetti that's stuck on there. And then when the feed was over, somebody said, "Hi, aren't you going to take that down?" Well, we had to stop, and it took a bit, but. The Noodle Nazi came from Daryl.
Daryl McDaniel?
Daniel, yeah, he was president at the time, and he said, "Yeah, that's typical of you Noodle Nazis."
So he has remained Noodle Nazi for a long time. I think there was a committee of those guys back there. Keith Huff was one of them, and Steve Johnston used to hang out back there, I think, a few times. Anyone else enjoy that noodle event? It was kind of cool. Gloria Lee, did you have something?
I was blessed to get to work on it last year. We did decorations, clean up, but the most fun was bussing cables and meeting people. We even had some of the most interesting people and their stories. It was a fun, fun time.
Thank you. How about, okay, Ron, thank you. I think the best part about an event like this is it really takes a lot of manpower and support from each other.
First Taste of Italy, we call it Spaghetti Feed then, was on Valentine's Day, and we advertised it as a cheap way to take your wife out to dinner. This was a $6 all you can eat spaghetti and garlic bread. Wasn't a very smart marketing move.
It was all fun. So we have had a few people that take that responsibility of being committee chair. And Carrie Ann, you managed to get here. I don't think you were here when we had announcements. So would you mind standing? This is our committee chair, Carrie Ann Botero. And it is a big task. She has subcommittees of several things that are going on. We've got the raffle people. So any of you want to provide a raffle or know someone that does want to, you can let her know. Yeah. And then of course we mentioned Marnie was taking sewing or handing out tickets. And Eric is collecting wine along with Greg Swanson. Yeah. Do you have something you want to share? I am calling on you. What would you like to share?
President Marilyn, fellow Lions and guests, I am excited to be the Taste of Italy co-chair again this year. It is a lot of work, though, and I apologize for coming in late. So I didn't hear about announcements, but we did have a wine lesson from Greg Swanson, and I don't see him right off the bat. Okay. So Greg Swanson is collecting the wine donations, and that's another big part of this is we all gather some of our wine or go out and purchase wine and donate that. And that way, we don't have to purchase that. It's not an expense for us at the Taste of Italy. Yet we're able to serve that for donations and we get income from that. But I did learn in our last meeting that white wine does go bad. I have no clue. So that's just something to keep in mind when you do the wine donation, is if you can go out, there's some great bottles for pretty inexpensive. You can go out and purchase some, you know, it's good and you don't have to worry about that. But basket donations is a huge thing. And then, of course, just the man labor for the day. So if you can't donate wine or you can't donate a basket, that's just perfectly fine. But if you could come help us, even for just a little bit that day, it's from morning to evening for a lot of us. So, and it's a lot of fun. So we would look forward to having you come help and get your family and friends and everyone you know over there for dinner. That's great.
Yeah, right. Be prepared. Do you have a meeting coming up? You had a meeting. Do you have another one scheduled? Okay. February 16th is a... That's passed.
How was that meeting?
I was going to follow her direction, but I realized. Okay. It will be announced later.
March 2nd.
Oh, who do you give... Carrie Ann, where do we give baskets and silent auction? Where do we deliver?
Next meeting, thank you for saying that. March 2nd
there you go.
Is the meeting. Next meeting at Life Mortgage, 6 p.m. We do it in the evening so all of you can get together and come. It's quick, half hour or hour. And American Family Insurance, we have sponsor sheets that we would like to have filled out when the basket is sent in, and that way we have some information on who did the donation. I have those if you would like to get some, come get them for me today. But American Family Insurance on Ocean Beach Highway in the Tucker Time parking lot, they have the room to store that stuff. So if you can drop that off or you can give that to me or someone in the committee, that's where everything will be all stored. And then we'll have a little party on getting everything put together too. Okay, is there any more questions on anything? Okay. Just a reminder that that is March 25th. We also have several people here. Hal?
Well, President Marilyn, I was remembering two things about the spaghetti thing that I thought were kind of exciting.
They won't let me sing there. What's up with that? The first one was my new lion, Keep Up. That was his very first project he worked on. And he had paid for the tickets and he invited his whole family. Yeah. And you know what happened? The noodle Nazi captured him. So Hal and Pat Palmer ended up sitting with the rest of the Huff family that night. And then the second one, and this kind of tells you the power of Facebook. A number of years ago, we weren't as assertive as in getting wine as we are now. And I recall after a Lions meeting, the next morning on Facebook in our Pioneer Lions area, they said, we need wine by Friday. And a little bit later they said, stop, we got 28 bottles. You know? So the power of Facebook for helping our club is there.
Thank you, Hal. I'm going to step out of my comfort zone a little bit. We had some cheerleaders over the last few years. Dina Martinson, Janice Hillman, and Jamie Holtzinger, I'm not sure what her last name is right now. But, you know, they would lead us along and pump us up and get us all excited about that event. So I'm just going to be Janice right now. Give me an L.
L.
Give me an I.
I.
And give me an O.
O.
And an N.
N.
Lions.
Lions.
Lions serve. We go out, make a little money, offer up service after we make that money. Is there any other things anyone wants to offer up? Where are my pom-poms? I should have had to bring pom-poms next week. I don't want to spell Longview.
Okay. Oh, all right.
Gosh, that takes me back, huh, Steve, just a little bit. One of those days you saw me out there relieving cheers. little private story. Do we have any senility today, sir? Got it?
President Marilyn, we have one person today, and I'm not going to find her because I like her so much. She came late.
Oh, Sandy.
She came late. And the sign-up sheet was up here at that time. So we're going to forgive you for that, Gary.
Okay. I'm just going to review announcements. We just talked about the Taste of Italy. Things that you can do to help out. Ron Stoppler and Rick, thank you so much. The wheelchair ramp tomorrow, Wednesday at 11 o'clock, 2316 Ocean Beach Highway. And if you'd like to be participating in that and help build those ramps, that's what we're doing, right? A ramp, okay. Also, tomorrow morning at 9 is a little work party at the shop. Rex Boswell made that announcement. Get things in order for the upcoming events for summer. Hal and Kathy Crawford encouraged us to invite a guest in March and encouraging us to get new members. Board meeting this Thursday at Bob Paul's at 7 a.m. And just a reminder again, District Governor Monty Ward will be here next week. And the events for the other clubs. Napa Vine having a spaghetti feed. We could go have spaghetti and then 2 weeks later have spaghetti again. That restaurant is Taste of Alaska at Napa Vine, and you can go at your leisure 2 to 6. They need to pre-sell tickets though, right? Kathy, do they need, or can you just show up? And let them know, okay. You know, they are a brand new club. They're about a year and a half old now, so they're doing really well. It's kind of great to support them. And Castle Rock, with the 70th anniversary, their tickets are for sale as well. And the quilt raffle, which is a really beautifully done quilt. Oh, yes, and Barbara, do you?
I think I'm going to have your Lion of the Month.
Our rookie Lion of the Month, right there.
Is it one? Okay. It is John Palmer.
John Palmer Sr. He wins a lot of things, doesn't he? Well, you got to look at it this way. My lottery sales rep over here says you can't win if you're not in. Well, we've got a blue tick drawing here. Yes?
Yeah, you guys know about the Peter.
Oh. Yes, and I forgot to mention that too. The Vader crab feed, Kathy, I apologize, forgot. 24th deadline for getting tickets, right?
That's this Friday.
That is this Friday.
Is March 4th.
March 4th. Okay, so see Kathy. And if you decide you want to go and you miss Kathy, you can let Steve and I know. We know how to get a hold of her and get that ordered. Okay, I think we got a joker draw today. Blue ticket. 5356 314. Hey, George! George gets the draw today.
It's a big one too, George. Might be $50.
Red ticket, 8212508. Hey, Dick McIntyre. Diabetes. Okay, I'm gonna write that down. How about Relay for Life?
First name,
Dick. Woohoo! Dick! Salvation Army. You're going to take it over there. Okay. So, na-na-na-na-na, no win?
Oh, yeah, I have six of spades.
Six of spades. Okay. Okay, I think with that, is there anything else I need to add to this meeting? Thanks for being so much fun, you guys.